أن يحضه على الآخرة وأن يأمره بتقوى الله. فاتقوا الله في عاجل أمركم وفي آجله، في السر وفي العلانية، فإنه من يتق الله يكفر عنه سيئاته ويعظم له أجرا، ومن يتق الله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. All praise and gratitude belongs to Allah alone, from whom we beseech guidance, sustenance, and facilitation for all of our affairs. I attest that God is one without partner. Nothing is like him. Nothing debilitates him. No deity exists save him. He is pre-existent without origin, eternal without end. He neither perishes nor ceases to exist. Nothing will be except what he wills. Imaginations cannot attain him. Comprehensions cannot perceive him. Alive, he never dies. All sustaining, he never sleeps. And I attest that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his chosen one, his preeminent prophet, and his messenger, with whom he is well pleased. We seek refuge in Allah from the wickedness of our desires and the ills of our actions. Truly, those who have been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall never be misguided. And those whom God has misguided will never find a soul that can bring them to guidance. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those whom He has favored with His guidance, inshallah. Indeed, we possess no knowledge except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us. We supplicate that He opens our perceptions to grasp knowledge which benefits us, and make of benefit the knowledge that He has blessed us with. I remind myself, as I remind you, of the need to always have taqwa in our hearts and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if we see Him, for surely and although we do not see Him, He always sees us. Indeed, we are blessed and favored by Al-Mawla Azza wa Jal to be here today to supplicate and to attend Al-Jum'ah. May He accept all of our good deeds and purify our intentions and purify our thoughts and perspectives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran in Surah Fussilat, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ ادفع بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍّ عَظِيمٍ وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزَغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And who could be better of speech than he who calls unto God and does what is just and right and says, verily, I am of those who have surrendered themselves to God. But since good and evil cannot be equal, repel evil with something that is better. And lo, he between whom and yourself was enmity may then become as though they had always been close unto you, a true friend. Yet to achieve this, it is not given to any but to those who are wont to be patient in adversity. It is not given to any but those who are endowed with the greatest of good fortunes. Hence, if it should happen that a prompting from Satan stirs you up to blind anger, seek refuge with Allah, with God. Behold, He alone is all-hearing, all-knowing. What I would like to talk to you about today is what it means to be a Muslim and what it means to be a mu'min or to be a believer. And of course, being a Muslim may mean different things to different people, both within the Muslim community as well as outside. And as is known by everyone here, the word Islam is always, or has always been rooted in the three-lettered word silm, which simply means peace, a state of peace. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ادْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ كَافَّةً وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُبِينٌ. This has often been translated into English by the majority of mufassirin or translators as entering into Islam. ادْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ كَافَّةً. As the word silm and Islam are used interchangeably. And to enter into a state of peace or Islam completely, and for all to enter into that state. The ayah continues to instruct not to follow the footsteps of a shaitan, as he is your declared enemy. A clear link between not being in a state of peace and in following the footsteps of a shaitan. Consider a clarifying hadith or saying of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, where he breaks it down for us. He says, عليه أفضل الصلاة والتسليم, لا تدخلون الجنة حتى تؤمنوا ولا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا أولا أدلكم على شيء إن فعلتموه تحاببتم أفشوا السلام بينكم. You would not enter the heavens until you believe, and you're not believers until you love one another. Shall I guide you to a thing that if you did, you would love one another? He said, alayhi afdhalu salatu wassalam, diffuse peace. The word that is used in that hadith is afshu, which is the opposite of withholding something or keeping a secret. So al-ifsha is to actually propagate, and not only just propagate, but to spread far and wide. And that's why the best word that comes to mind is to diffuse peace into every nook and every cranny. Not just simply spread it, but rather, as you might say today, make peace go viral. Peace is ingrained and is inculcated into a Muslim's life. We utter prayers and supplications at least 5 times a day, and within each, when we sit for the Abrahamic prayer, we started with At-tahiyyatu lillahi was-salawatu at-tayyibat As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. These aren't hollow words that we utter. These aren't empty promises that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam taught us. And if for a fleeting moment they do become hollow words or habitual words, we are reminded of them again as we conclude our salah and we face the right and we say assalamu alaikum once more, and then we face to the left and say the same thing, as if to be reminded that our mission as Muslims is in fact to spread peace. And just like we learn our life lessons from those who are closest to us, such as our family or our community, the whole point is to make it habitual, behaviorally habitual, something that we say repeatedly throughout the entire day ought to become our akhlaq and our khuluq, something more than just simply lip utterance that is betrayed or belied by actions that are anything but peaceful. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns in the verse immediately following this beautiful injunction of entering into peace, that the alternative to entering into peace is to follow the footsteps of Satan. So just as one gets supremely offended when they realize that somebody has duped them or somebody has deceived them, every single one of us should feel primarily offended if we ever find ourselves in a state that is nothing but a peaceful state, both internally and externally, as to how we treat others. Because simply put, we would be following the footsteps of Satan. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us specifically and explicitly against doing so. Now back to Surah Fussilat that I started out with, the ayah, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. But since good and evil cannot be equal, repel evil with that which is better, and lo, he between whom and yourself was enmity may become as if they had always been a close and a true friend. In this case, repel or push back with that which is better. And almost instantly, the person with whom you had enmity becomes a dear friend. Another reading suggests that the person with whom you have enmity is to be considered as if they were a dear friend, and to be extended the courtesy thereof. So even if that person is mistreating you, rather than letting them set the standard by which you behave as a Muslim, you ought to remember that you always escalate and elevate up rather than race with someone down to the bottom. Rasul taught us that al-ghadab min ash-shaytan وإن الشيطان خلق من النار وإنما تطفأ النار بالماء فإذا غضب أحدكم فليتوضأ. So again, nothing is left up to interpretation or left up to wondering what it is that is being meant by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet alayhi afdal salatu wassalam seeks for us to become, seeks for us to be. وَقَدْ اسْتَبَّ رَجُلَانِ عِنْدَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَاشْتَدَّ غَضَبُ أَحَدُهُمَا فَقَالَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ كَلِمَةً لَوْ قَالَهَا لَذَهَبَ عَنْهُمَا يَجِدْ اللَّهُمَّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. That's what you say when you're upset. That's what you say when you are mad, when things aren't going your way. That's probably the first step of following khutuwat al-shaytan. You dislodge, you delink by saying inni a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Subhanallah. Kindness can and does overpower any retaliation that a person may have. And even though the Quran discusses just retribution or al-qasas and sets the limits or al-hudud to protect people's rights upon one another, oftentimes forgiveness is better. The injunction to repel with that which is better indeed is a means to actualize forgiveness. For I can easily and fluidly forgive a person that I have an affinity towards. I'll be more tolerant. I'll be more accommodating to somebody that I care for, that I care about. And that's what Al-Qur'an al-Kareem, that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to have as our disposition. That people that are wronging us, people that might be mistreating us, are in fact to be treated well, rather than for us to treat them the way they've treated us. The next ayah articulates how a person can practice that recommended formula of goodness. The key, as always, is patience. Yet to achieve this, it is not given to any but those who are wont to be patient in adversity. It may be easy to be patient when things are going good. No skin off our back, as they say. But it's actually in adversity, when things aren't going our way, that's when patience counts. It is not given to any but to those who are endowed with the greatest of good fortune. Hence, if it should happen that a prompting from Satan stirs you up to blind anger, seek refuge with God. Behold, He alone is all-hearing, all-knowing. So perspective is of great importance. That which we fill our minds with is as important as the physical air that we breathe, or the water that we drink, or the food that we consume. Orienting oneself with God's commandment and the example of the Prophet ﷺ is amongst the most effective ways to impact society. Extending goodwill, shunning ill thoughts, backbiting, and an abasive nafs are a guarantee for clarifying the soul from that which tarnishes it. The Prophet ﷺ gave us numerous lessons in orienting the instincts and instructing the soul in where it should find comfort. When he used to tell Sayyiduna Bilal radiallahu anhu at prayer time, now I want you to think about this. He wouldn't tell Sayyidina Bilal, قُمْ فَأَذِّنْ. That's not what he used to say. Call the prayer, it's prayer time. He used to tell Bilal, عليه رضوان الله, أَرِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَال. Comfort us with it, O Bilal, in a reference to As-Salaam. Now think about the impact of what those blessed words that are uttered by Rasul al-A'zam alayhi salatu wasalam will have on the companions, and it should have on us listening to this story 1439 years later. It should have exactly the same impact, which is we should find our comfort in as-salat. You know, back in the day, I thought I'd never say this, back in the day, right? But back in the day when computer programming started, you used to have to define those commands that you're going to use. Perhaps it's still the same way. You define them. You say, I'm going to be using this logic or these words to program or to write my program. And this is exactly what I'm talking about. It is in your hands to define concepts of understanding of things that are around you. If you're constantly looking at things negatively, and if you're constantly thinking that everybody is out there to get you, then it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. You're the one who has defined your own reality. So when Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam tells Sayyiduna Bilal, Ridwanullah alayh, arihna biha ya Bilal, he's defining that within the prayer is where you shall find comfort. If you don't find comfort, that's fine. Keep working at it and you will find comfort in it, because that's what it's meant to be. It is an object in to itself for you to find comfort in as-salah. وَعَلَى ذَلِكَ فَقِسْ. You can take this and scale it to everything else in life. You're the one that defines it. Do not let others define your reality for you. May we always find comfort in our iman and our submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam used to instruct his companions, or those who would visit with him, when they start to speak about another companion that may not be amongst them. And please pay attention to this. Rasul didn't used to say, oh, tell me more. Keep it going. What else did they do? Rasul used to say, La tughiru sadri ala ashabi. أريد أن أخرج إليكم سليم الصدر. So rather than being entertained or enjoying or encouraging backbiting or people that are conveying news about those who may not be within the majlis of Rasulullah ﷺ, he used to stop them at the source. He's stopping pollution of the mind at the source. He's not allowing it to even come into his ears, alayhi abdullah wasalam, for him to process it and that doubt to start filtering to his heart. He used to say, La tughiru sadri, do not make my chest constricted or filled with hatred towards any of you, because I would like to come out to all of you salim al-sadr. It's all in your control. You're always in control. So do not cause my chest or my heart to be distraught over my companions. I want to always have a clean heart or clean chest when I come out to you. The prophet is giving us a clear lesson of controlling pollution at the source. Please exercise that. That's more important to actually embody that particular teaching than anything else that may be esoteric or artificial or superficial about what you might have heard the Prophet ﷺ may have done. Because if our sadr is saleem, then everything else falls into order. But if our sadr is polluted, then that too bleeds into everything else that we do. Allahumma guide us to that which is better for us in this life and in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says and continues to perpetually say, إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم ردنا إلى دينك ردا جميلا اللهم آت أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وارحم موتانا اللهم أحينا على الإسلام وأمتنا على الإيمان O God, we seek protection with you from worry and from grief, and we seek protection with you from helplessness and from laziness, and we seek protection with you from cowardice and from stinginess, and we seek protection with you from the overpowering of debt and from the oppression of men. Allah commands justice, the doing of good, the liberality to kith and to kin, and He forbids all shameful deeds and injustices and rebellions. He instructs you that you may receive admonition. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ وَأَجَلُّ وَأَعْظَمُ أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على السلام حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
حق لا إله إلا الله أقامها وأدامها الله سووا صفوفكم وسدوا الخلل make the line straight leave no gaps أثابني وأثابكم الله الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
couple of announcements. First of all, this coming Tuesday at 6 p.m. in the Petrie Room, we have a Talk Faith event. So this will be an interfaith with other religious organizations on campus. So that's this coming Tuesday at 6 p.m. in the Petrie Room right here. And then on Thursday, we have a halaqa at 6 p.m. with Brother Jawad Rasul. And that will be in Student Center Room 321. And again, that's Thursday, 6 p.m. And then next Friday, after Jummah, we have our movie night. So, and that's going to be in the Instructional Center, room 115. And February 5th, we're having an event with the other MSAs in the Atlanta area, so Georgia State, Emory, and Abney Scott. We're having a World Hijab Day at Abney Scott, and that's on February 5th in the evening. The details for that are in the email and on Facebook. And Hunger Walk sign up is open, so if you're interested to sign up for the Hunger Walk, it happens once a year, and the date for that is February 25th. Sign up closes before then, so make sure to do that. And finally, we have our annual FIFA and Super Smash Bros. Tournament on February 9th. So the sign up for that Google Doc is also on the email. So if you're interested, sign up.